Hello everybody, my name is Walter, and in this tutorial I'll show you how you can build my 12 block wide, supercharged and infinitely expandable retracting slime floor. If you already watched my 12 block high, supercharged and infinitely expandable slime door designs, you might recognize a lot of the things I'm building in this tutorial, because it's pretty much the same, just flipped in the horizontal. This floor opens and closes in about 3 seconds and can be used, for example, in an Indiana Jones style retracting floor trap. Especially since the slimes in the floor slow down any enemy or player that tries to escape. So now, how much space will you need? From the starting point of your floor, you're gonna need 6 extra blocks to the back, and behind the wall you'll need another 9 blocks of space for the circuits and the mechanics. Now, what resources will you need? You'll need a lot of sticky pistons, 2 normal pistons, 2 droppers and 2 hoppers, quite a lot of redstone, a couple of redstone repeaters and comparators. The number of the repeaters, comparators and the sticky pistons as well as the redstone depends on how long your floor will be. Then you might need a lever, a few buttons, a couple of torches. Then you'll need a few building blocks. First you need at least one kind of building block that can be pushed by pistons and slime blocks, then a building block that can't be pushed, like obsidian. Then you'll need a lot of slime blocks, and I would actually suggest you build a slime farm before you start building this one here. You need a few glowstone blocks and at least 2 stone slabs. Everywhere where you use a glowstone block, you could also use an upside down stone slab. The glowstone just helps with lighting up your circuits. So, that were the resources you need. Now, let's start with the tutorial. Okay, now the first thing you have to do is decide where you want your floor to start. In this case, I want my floor to start from this point on, and just one thing, both sides are pretty much the same, they are just mirrored to each other, and one is shifted by one block along this build. So what you build first is this little structure out of obsidian here. It's 6 blocks in this direction and 6 blocks in this direction. So it's the total width of your door, floor. Just fill in those 6 blocks here, so it looks like this. Good, now I show you how you can build the right side of this build. And the left side, as I already said, is just mirrored. So, to start off, from this corner on, go one block down, and then another block and place 6 blocks in a row like this. So next, grab some obsidian and place 6 blocks like this. At the end, put another normal block. Now, put some repeaters on those normal blocks here. Make sure they're all in the on the default setting. And now repeat this process until you are at the end of your retracting floor. So, when you're finished with this part, grab some sticky pistons, place one on top of this normal block here, then behind it go up by 2 blocks, and place a pillar of 5 sticky pistons like this. Then you can take out those blocks. You don't need them anymore. Next, grab some slime blocks and place a pillar of 6 like this, so it connects all of those sticky pistons, and another 6 slime blocks going all the way to here. Then grab some building blocks and place 6 like this. They'll make the actual retracting floor. Okay, then grab a normal block, put it besides this first piston here, and then make a little stair out of 4 obsidian going downwards like this. Make the same thing on the other side. Then place 3 normal blocks here. Now grab a comparator, some redstone, and run it along those stairs. And the first module is done now. Now just repeat this until you're at the end of this floor. So, when you're done with those modules, the next thing you should do is actually building some floor here. For this, go out 5 blocks from here and 6 blocks in this direction. So, next, grab a lever, place it here, turn it on. Take the output with a repeater and place 7 redstone like this. This should actually be obsidian here. So then place another 6 redstone like this. Go up 1 block here and here and place a redstone torch here. Then put a normal block besides the torch and on top of it, then another block here and on top of it. So then put a repeater in this gap here, facing towards the torch, on 4 ticks. Put redstone dust on those 2 blocks and a torch on both of them too. Then put a normal block on top of this redstone here. Put redstone on top of this block, let it run in this block. Next, it's time for the piston, the normal piston. Place it besides this block here, and a sticky piston facing upwards behind it. Place 4 more blocks like this, and 3 more blocks in those corners here. Then some redstone in on those 2 blocks, and another normal block here to cut off this redstone wire here. Then put a comparator here and another comparator here. This one you put on the subtraction mode. Then place another block here with a comparator on top of it. Next, grab a dropper, place it here, and a hopper facing towards this dropper. Then grab 5 items and put them in the dropper, like this. Next, go in front of this torch here. Place a block with redstone on top of it, going into this sticky piston with a normal block on top of it. Then put another normal block here with a redstone repeater. Make sure it's on 1 tick. Running into this block and make a little stair like this. Put some redstone on top of it. Now you put a block here. Behind this block here, where the comparator is facing, 3 normal blocks like this. put some redstone dust here, a block on top of it again to cut off the wire, then two repeaters here and here, this one put on two ticks. Now we need a little obsidian, glowstone I mean, put it here, put a sticky piston besides this block here, and a block hovering above it. Then place here another normal block and connect this with some redstone. So next, take out this redstone and place a normal block here, just a little mistake I made. Put the redstone on top of it. Now we need another block of glowstone. Put it on top of this redstone here. Then place a normal block besides it and go up one block on both sides. Place some redstone on top of those blocks. Then place a normal block here, followed by a glowstone, followed by three normal blocks. Put a repeater here. Then four redstone like this. Next, place five blocks like this in a row and put four repeaters like this. Put this one here on two ticks, the rest you leave on one tick. Then the same thing on this side here, one on two ticks and three on one tick. Connect this one here with another repeater. And finally put some redstone. Then go out one block here, put redstone on top of it. Now we need a slab. Put it here. Put a redstone repeater on top of it. Like this. Facing into this sticky piston with a normal block on top of it. And finally, place those two blocks here, and make this little staircase here. Put some redstone down to here and connect it all. Now, put a block of glowstone above this redstone here, put some redstone on top of it, and again a normal block on top of this to cut off the wire. Then another normal block here, put in this corner a sticky piston with two slime blocks in front of it, and finally here a normal block cutting off this wire. Then put a block above this repeater here on the two ticks and go out one block in this direction. Make the same thing here. Then go out five blocks like this, then another four blocks here, put another block here for comparator on top of this, then put another four comparators like this, put them all on the subtraction mode and place some redstone. Then put a normal block behind this comparator here, with redstone torch on top of it, and the same thing here on this side. Then put a repeater here on two ticks, and for the moment place a lever here. Now we have to set this circuit here in the right state. The right state is when the redstone power reaches this block here, but not this block here. So it's when those comparators are turned on, but those pistons here aren't. In this case we need two really short pulses, and that should do the trick. If you gave it too much power here, just put this comparator here in the normal mode, then in the subtraction mode again, and do the thing over again. So, like this. Then place some redstone here, then put a block behind this repeater, comparator here. Put a block down here. Go up one block again. Down again. Down. Then up again. And two blocks here. And run some redstone wire like this. And here in this gap, put a repeater also on two ticks. And that should do the trick. Now, fetch a button to test this whole thing out and place it on this block here and activate it. And as you can see, the door closes completely and I am scouted actually. Okay, before you try opening this floor now, we have to add a little something I forgot earlier. For that, go to this corner here and place a button or a lever on top of the below this block here. So the redstone wire goes directly into this block and doesn't power this obsidian block here. Really important, or the door, the floor won't open completely. But now, as you can see, it works. And as you can see, if you put a block here, it also gets activated. That's important later when we are connecting the both sides. Now, the next thing you should do is building the same thing, just mirrored on the left side. Okay, now that the second half of this floor is done, the last thing we have to do is actually connecting those two. And here the timing is really important. So sometimes you have to try a little thing out. So the first thing you have to do is actually taking out those few redstone components here. Then place a sticky piston facing towards the right side here. Put a block of obsidian besides this one here and put a lever or a button here so that this redstone here doesn't power this block here, this sticky piston here. So then put 12 slime blocks in a row like this. It should end just one block before it activates the right side. Then you will actually have to try this part out a bit. Either you go directly with some redstone around here, or you put a repeater on one tick here and thus delay the power by one tick. So this redstone here actually is our input. So if we put a normal block on top of it and a button on this block and push it, you can see both sides are working in sync, and if you open it again, it works perfectly. If the timing isn't right, for example like this, it closes, but the opening is out of sync. As you can see, only the first modules close, open. In this case, just close the whole thing again, and it should work if you make the timing right. Sometimes only this module here retracts, and this one here stays. That's when this side here takes too long, as you can see here. If you try closing this one, you see this one here gets retracted one time. In this case, you have to actually rebuild this one a bit. So just place those two blocks here and remove them from here. And if you get the timing right, then it works again. So now that we are done with the actual building part, You can actually take the output from this block down here too, if you're using this not as a floor but as a ceiling. Now, the last thing you have to do is actually building a little bit more of the floor. Make sure everything that gets in contact with slime blocks is made of obsidian. If you accidentally run this, just place another block here and it goes back in the open position. And especially be careful to place 6 obsidian blocks as a pillar here, because in the closed position those slime blocks here are directly behind the walls. The rest can be made of out of normal blocks. Of course, behind these slime blocks you also need some obsidian, but the rest can be any block you want. There's no real limitation to that. And we are done. As you can see, I filled out those walls and I actually extended the floor to the sides a bit. And well, that's the retracting floor. If you don't want to use a button to activate it, you could actually use some kind of trap that gives a short redstone pulse and run this pulse into this block or this block, and well, the floor opens, just like in any Indiana Jones or Lara Croft film you might see. Okay, so that was how you can build my 12 block wide, infinitely expandable and supercharged retracting floor in the first version. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and see ya!